right, we're here in my office, and look who came by. It was Peter Vanderkay, who made his mark at Michigan, won 4 Olympic medals, 2 of them gold, 2 bronze. When the games start, do you like get all freaked out, or do you like all excited and jacked up, ready to go?
Yeah, and this is the first one I haven't been a part of in, what, I guess, since 2000. So I'm really excited just to watch like everyone else and cheer on the team.
You swam with Michael Phelps. What's that whole aura like around Michael Phelps? Because 22 medals, 18 of them gold. It must be freaky at times.
He's incredible. I mean, he's the greatest Olympian of all time, greatest swimmer of all time. And to be able to train with him and learn from him and watch, and especially when he went through that experience in Beijing and win the 8 golds, was incredible. It was a piece of history.
Yeah. And it's like out of the water, what's he like? Is he like a normal guy?
He's a normal guy. He likes movies and music and same stuff we all like, so. He's pretty easy to get to know once you get to know him a little bit.
Right, I was going to say, because the media sort of made him into this superhero with a cape and everything. That's not what he is at all.
Yeah, and he's a dad now, so he's just a family guy.
Right. Okay, so what are you seeing this year? Are you got any wild predictions? Are you really excited about the Olympics?
I'm excited to see some of the new faces on the team. There's a lot of turnover. Guys like me are off the team. Younger people are on it now. So I think seeing them compete is going to be really exciting, and hopefully they can continue that legacy of USA, Team USA dominating the swimming.
Yeah. Now, you carry this bag everywhere, am I correct?
Not everywhere.
But look at the stuff in it. This is really, look at this. This is a gold medal. This is from Beijing. Is that unbelievable? Look at that.
Okay. And a bronze.
This is a bronze from Beijing also. Honest to goodness, when I first saw it, I said, is that chocolate? But it's not. It's beautiful. It's really beautiful. Here's another gold. This one is from...
That's Athens, 2004.
2004, my God, look how beautiful that is. And then this is my favorite. Look at the size of this bronze from London, 2012. But this is the heaviness of this thing in comparison to these others. It's kind of amazing. I think England went a little overboard. But, you
know. Yeah, they spent some money on these.
So what do you do with this stuff? You're like just hanging on your...
I just keep them around. You know, sometimes I'll talk to schools and kids and do clinics, and they're fun to share with people. So they're getting a little bit tattered, but it's growing up in this community, it's fun to share that experience.
And I would think just the Olympic experience is just something that never leaves you. I mean, you're a part of that forever and ever and ever.
Yeah, a lot of memories coming back this week as everyone's amping up for the game. So I'm just ready to cheer them on.
Okay.
I think it's going to be awesome.
Great. And you can do that right here watching on Local 4. We've got the Olympics opening ceremonies Friday night. Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you.
Or hang out for a while. You know, nobody comes in here.